In 1977, Johnny Rotten was the most infamous figure in Britain. I am an anti-coaster. I am an anarchoaster. He was the face of the Sex Pistols, purveyors of chaos who spat in the face of the establishment. In the apoplectic words of one critic, the greatest threat to British youth since Hitler. The Pistols imploded in January 1978 at their last gig in San Francisco, and Rotten's farewell message to the crowd was predictably withering.
Ah, ha, ha. Ever get the feeling you've been cheated?
But Rotten was to re-emerge a few months later under his real name, John Lydon. He bemused many of his followers with his new, defiantly experimental band, Public Image Limited. This year, Lydon announced he was reviving Pill after nearly two decades. And I'm thrilled, because ever since my teens, he's been one of my real heroes. Not just a pop star, but a poet and a prophet, up there with Blake or Rambo. I always remember when this came out. It's Metal Box by Pill. It's their legendary album, 1979. I'd just turned 18, and I went out and bought a copy of it, and it struck me as a kind of weird, almost like an archaeological relic. It's something that's designed to feel as if it's somehow been dug up. And now that it's gone all rusty, it really does feel like that. Part of the challenge of the album, apart from it being an oral challenge, was just getting the damn thing open without breaking your fingernails. But then, actually, playing the album posed its own separate problem. Because I put it on, and I started listening to it. I thought, my God! What is this extraordinary noise? I remember when I first put it, my girlfriend immediately left the room. Everybody I lived with left. It's a, you can't listen to this. And I was thinking, this is just... this is so profound. Can you look at the guy who made Anarchy in the UK? This is where he's moved to in just 2 years. He's a genius. This is astonishing. And then a friend of mine said, you do know you're playing it at the wrong speed.
I'm
on my way to meet Lydon at his rehearsal studio. I was feeling a little nervous. He's famously a man who hasn't suffered fools gladly, especially when talking about Pill.
Now, I was asked here, right, to interview with the band here, Pill, but now, like, we're facing a cheapskate comedy interrogation act, and it just ain't on, pal. It's a joke. It's a farce.
Well, it sounds like we've heard this story before.
Really? Would you like to tell me where? Good night.
Good night.
And when I first meet John, it's pretty clear that he hasn't mellowed that much over the decades.
Hello, Culture Show. I'm very uncomfortable. They've got me on a drum stool. I'm not used to sitting up.
I like the fact we've got these trains going overhead. Somehow they're quite cool as well.
It's London, isn't it? You know, here we are, swanking it with the big knobs. It's grim up north, but it's grim down south too. Don't forget it.
So, John, why... why now?
You said this wasn't going to be hard. Why now? Well, why not? Many, many reasons. I mean, it's obvious, really, to me, but maybe not to you, that I've been working fairly consistently hard over the years. I'm surprised that it's taken so long for me to get Pill back on the road. But it is so expensive to just restart, and it, 'cause everything is from scratch all over again. But it'd be well worth it. Be a complete orgasm of a performance. And I hate to keep saying this, but, you know, Country Life Butter, the money did help. I buy Country Life because I think it tastes the best.
What does Pill mean to you as opposed to what the Pistols meant to you?
Oddly enough, it's freer. I could get into like emotions, you know, in a much deeper way. I can cry my eyes out in half of these songs and usually end up doing exactly that because they're from the heart and soul. Well, the Sex Pistols is an act of aggression, really, against oppression. It was a very, very good start, I would think, for anyone who wanted to enter the wonderful world of pop music. So if you just, you know, go on, there you go. You look like a saucy young bugger. Have some fun, and I did. I think I did well with the Pistols, but I've never written a song in it that I don't believe in. And I took that and advanced that a couple of stages further in Pill. Pill is the experimental side of me, but it's also the more truer and honest. You never listen to a word that I said. You only see me by the class of my wife. I did the interest, got so much deeper. They must have been the top of my house. The public came in. I deal with a lot of real personal issues and personal pain in public image, and the Sex Pistols really isn't a format for that.
No, I always thought, the Sex Pistols was the first music that, pop music, that I really loved. I mean, really thought, wow, I can throw all that other stuff I've been pretending to like away.
10cc.
Exactly. You could probably, yeah, my whole record collection, it was, oh, thank God, that can just go now.
I was there at the right time.
Well, you certainly were.
And nobody else was, so, ha.
I was just, before we came to do this interview, I was opening up Metal Box, and I remember...
You've managed to, I can't
exactly.
get it open.
I can barely get it open. I was just stunned by how, the sort of, the distance that you travelled from Anarchy in the UK to that.
For me, that was no great leap. I mean, The Pistols, in the darkest days towards the end of the first breakup, should we say, I was writing songs like Religion. But I knew the band, the Pistols, really couldn't get to grips with a song like that. And it just wasn't working. And, you know, Sid, God bless his soul, there's no way he could get around a bass line. So for me, it wasn't an enormous leap. It was a gradual progression into things, or degression, according to your lack of taste. Religion has caused the most serious harm to the world as we know it. Definitely history is riddled with it. I should know. I've got an A-level in history. I'd like to see it eliminated.
You pray to the Holy Ghost when you sack your host. Do you read who's dead in the Irish Post? Do you give away the cash? You can't afford unbended knees and pray to the Lord. Sexy priest, sanctimonious mayor. He takes the money, you take the
money. So that's a song that many people tell me frightens them. And I remember earlier reviews said, don't play with the lights off. I remember that one review. I agreed. It does, it sends chills down the spine. But when I'm writing it, it seemed kind of corny, but I went ahead with it anyway, because sometimes I can be corny, but it's actually the most genuine root cause to the problem.